We're still in Numbers 33. Let's just have a little look at the end of Numbers 33. These instructions for when they cross the Jordan and go into this land of Canaan. How they are to deal with the idols and pagan practices that they come across there. Because they might think, well, we'll avoid those things, but we just don't want to get involved. And let's just ignore them. Let's pretend they're not there. And we will just focus on being faithful to the Lord ourselves, and we'll just try to ignore all this kind of idolatry stuff that's in the land. But that won't do. Let's listen. It says, the Lord spoke to Moses, speak to the children of Israel, say to them, when you've crossed the Jordan into the land of Canaan, then you shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you. Destroy all their engraved stones. Destroy all their molded images. And destroy or demolish all their high places. Destroy, demolish. And then verse 55 is this warning. But if you do not drive out the inhabitants of the land from before you, then it shall be that those whom you let remain shall be irritants in your eyes and thorns in your side. And that concept of the thorns like a curse. Thinking back to Genesis 3, the curse, thorns, and they shall harass you in the land where you dwell. So the lesson from that is when there are idols and these sources of constant pagan temptation in our lives, we cannot just pack those things away or just ignore them and say, I'll just pack that part of my life away and I won't touch it. I won't touch those things, but that's fine. I'll just try and ignore them. That doesn't work. Idols and our false gods and these worldly practices and things in our lives, they have to be destroyed, demolished. We cannot have a kind of compromise with the idolatry and immorality and paganism that's in our lives. We cannot do that. We can't just pack them away or ignore them. They have to be smashed, demolished, destroyed. Idols have to be destroyed. And I always take that in my own life. It's like when Jesus says, if your eye offends you, if it's what you're looking at, pluck out your eye. If it's your hand, it's what you're doing, chop off your hand. If it's your foot, where your foot's taking, where you're going, cut off your foot. You can't compromise. You can't be gentle in getting rid of our idols and our false gods. It requires violence and destruction, even injury, to get rid of these things. Radical, decisive surgery to cut out the idols and the false gods from us. And that's even that concept of circumcision, the cutting off of flesh. It's always painful. It's always destructive to do these things. It's never a gentle process to get rid of our idols and false gods. This is a passage that's meant a lot to me, and that warning of verse 55, that if we compromise with these false gods and idols, they will be a constant curse to us, constantly damaging us, irritating us, pulling us down, harming us. We have to make a clean break, because idolatry, immorality, greed, false gods, they're there. They're around us the whole time. We have to cut them out of our lives with great zeal and destruction. Challenging words, but great wisdom.